Portrait of So began as incidental music for a dance production involving four Norwegian folk dancers and four kung fu monks. The youngest of these was So Wenbing. He was about 10 years old at the time, and his journey became integral to the entire show. And later on, NRK, the Norwegian state television, decided to make a TV ballet based on this dance production, and then in doing so, they also wanted me to orchestrate the music. And I got to recast and rethink and reconceptualize a lot of what I'd written, and it occurred to me that I could sort of cast Zo's music as a concertino for flute and orchestra, in which the flute plays the role of So, so to speak. And that's what this piece is about. Marble songs were written in response to the beautiful artistry of Norwegian sculptor Håkon Anton Fagerås. I wanted to see if I could try to capture the beautiful paradox of stillness and spontaneity in his work. There is a plasticity and a restlessness to what he does that I find incredibly compelling and very moving and very vibrant and touching. And so I wanted to see if I could try to do in music what he does in marble. Shostakovich in Memoriam was originally the first movement of my first symphony, written in 2006 for the Shostakovich Centenary. And I wrote the entire symphony as a tribute to one of my favorite composers, and one of the composers who's been most influential and most crucial in my life, and a composer that I admire tremendously. Of course, one of the well-known features of his work is the Shostakovich motto, the DSCH motto. And I wanted to base my symphony on that motto, but not really use it the way that Shostakovich uses the motto, but to use it more, perhaps on a larger scale in a sense. So the movements of the symphony were each based on one of those pitches. But the first movement consists solely of those four pitches. There are only four pitches in that piece. And that, I think, lent a certain austerity to the music. That I've written, it's one of the pieces that feels the most linked to my own life, and it's a very personal piece for me, and it's a piece that's difficult to talk about because I feel that if I address it, I might get in the way of the listener's perception of the piece, and I don't want to do that. Suffice it to say that it's a piece about the loss of love and about questioning love and hopefully about redemption of love.